Okay, yeah, so in this video I want to talk about getting a job, because the main purpose of initiating this tutorial is for people to watch the tutorial and go get a job. So I want to talk about how to get a job as a software developer. If you've learned software development, so how do you get a job? That is the fundamental thing, the fundamental question: how do you get a job? So before you even start talking about getting a job, you need to have a CV. You need to have a clean, workable CV. And to make things a bit easier, I will give out a copy of my CV, the CV I use to apply for a job as a software developer. I will give it out so that you see the format and you use that to create your own CV, you know, and put your experience and the rest. So that is all about CV. I will give you a copy of my CV so that you use as a guide. That's what I've used, and at least it has earned me some success. So in addition to having a clean CV, you know, this business, you have to give yourself some advantage. You need to have what? A GitHub account. A GitHub account is where you host all your GitHub account is just like your Facebook account. Your Facebook account for where you store and display your code. Why do you need a GitHub account? In most cases, recruiters don't even want to start bothering calling you to interview. All they want to do is, where is the code you've produced? Where is the code you've written? And in fact, based on the code you've written, they might decide to either employ you or not to call you for an interview or not to call you for an interview. So that's why you need to have a GitHub account. Other candidates will also have their own GitHub account. So you too, you need to have your own GitHub account. So that's where you store all your code. So all the exercises we'll be doing, you will push those exercises to your GitHub account, and then you can put a link of your GitHub account to your CV, and then show to your prospective employees that this is what I've been doing. In addition to your GitHub account, you need to have the website for GitHub, of course, is github.com. If you just type GitHub, it will take you to their website. You register, it's free of charge. So if it is free of charge, there's no point not registering. So in addition to your GitHub account, you need to have a LinkedIn account. You know, LinkedIn, you have to be professional. You know, everything you are doing is to everything in everything supports your professionalism. You know, you want to show that you are a professional in this field. You know, Timaya will say everything follow for promo. You know, your LinkedIn will also support you to show what you are capable of. And in addition to LinkedIn, I will also suggest part of you develop a small project, you can go register with Medium and just write, shoot videos. It's free. You can use your phone to just shoot video. Okay, hi, my name is this. I got interested in software. I watched Ebenezer's video and I got interested in software development and I decided to develop software. Just shoot any video and post. Shoot, write a blog post. Just write anything and post. If you have access to computer, you know, if you have access to computer, you can just create image and just post. Everything follow for promo. It will kind of like expose you. So that's what I'm just trying to say. In addition to your LinkedIn profile, you have to also cultivate a habit of creating content, because it is through content, the content you create, that people will know, oh, this guy knows how to develop. And in most cases, people will just give you a job without calling you for an interview. So, and the type of content you need is, like if you have a blog post where you write everything, in fact, you can even start documenting your journey. You can start documenting all the things you are learning. And you can either write it in, if you have a LinkedIn profile, there's a section where you can write an article. You can document everything in that section and publish. And people will look at what you've done. If you're a developer, people will want to employ you. That is the truth about it. People will be hustling, come work for us, come work for us. So create content in addition to your LinkedIn profile. You can create your content in your LinkedIn profile, or you can, if you have a blog, you can use LinkedIn articles. You can use Medium, that is medium.com. Or if you have a blog, you can create content, you can shoot video, you can write articles, you can shoot videos telling people that, see what I'm doing. Then you can also just create images. So articles, videos, images, you can combine them, create, it will market you. In fact, you can decide, as I said earlier on, you can decide to start documenting the journeys you've taken so far in your software development endeavor. So that is it. It will help promote you. It will help promote you, expose you to people that will employ you. It's easy. Then once you are done with this, we talk about where do you then look for job. Then in looking for job, where to look for job, I have like four stuff here. Then you can look for job locally. If you are in Nigeria, there are so many companies that will employ you. So you can look for job locally in Nigeria. You can look for banks that have software development roles. Or you can look for, you might want to go through organizations like Andela. If you are very good and they are satisfied, they will employ you. And then you have all these startups that are coming up. The one thing that is paining me is that companies in Nigeria are outsourcing their jobs, while at the same time, Nigerians are complaining that they don't have a job. So that is part of the reason why I decided to do this video. It doesn't make sense to me personally that companies in Nigeria are outsourcing their job, while Nigerians are complaining that they don't have a job. You see, so you can make yourself professional and look for job locally in Nigeria. They pay very high. In fact, I heard that some even pay up to ₦1 million. Then, in addition to looking for job locally, you can look for job internationally. You can catalog all the whole job websites in the world, UK, US, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, and start applying for their software role. I know visa might be an issue, but some organizations, some companies might decide to allow you to work remotely if the visa becomes an issue, or they can even sponsor you, pay for your visa, so that you, if you are very good, they will bring you. Period. It has been democratized, you know. So locally, you can look for jobs locally. Like you can go to Jobberman, you can go to all these, or you can list all the companies and see if they have software development role. Like I said, if you have been promoting yourself, you have a blog, if you have a video post, if you have all those things, you don't even need to. The companies will identify you and come for you. You see, that is the benefit of promoting yourself. Then internationally, look for all these career websites, international career websites. Look for software development roles and start applying. They might employ you, they might not, but start applying. Some might be a bit skeptical about visa, but they can sponsor you. Some they can decide, okay, just work remotely from Nigeria if you are very good. Then another thing you can do when you come, there's another thing I'm trying to research on, but I've not been able to fully. There is this European blue passport, European blue card. So what I'm trying to research is it possible if I'm a Nigerian and I'm an expert in software development and I get a job, what a blue visa is all about is if you apply for the blue visa stuff, you apply your CV, then the companies will look at your CV. And if they employ you, the European Immigration Agency will not give you visa. But I'm trying to explore that, but I don't really know how that. I have the application, but I've not pushed through the application. So that's another thing I'm looking at. So if you are very good, you apply for that. There are so many jobs in Europe. There are so many jobs in Europe. In fact, if you research job shortage in tech industry, job shortage, and it will give you all the whole problem. They will say there is labor market shortage and everything. So because of that, the European immigration body decided to have this EU blue card. So what you do is you register there, put your CV there. Recruiters will go to their database, look for your CV. If they are okay with your CV, then they will employ you. Then European immigration will not give you visa. So I'm trying to see, can they give you, like, do they do all these like short-time visa, or how it works? Well, you can explore that. That's a very good avenue to explore. Do your research and you can make also look at all these countries and see if there is any way, any short program they have for IT professionals, for professionals to come over. You know, that is what you can do to get a job internationally. Then, of course, I've talked about LinkedIn. LinkedIn is another good place you can look for job on. Like if you are in a developed world, if you're in a developed country, because all this thing I've been making it based on if you're in Nigeria, if you're in a developed world, it's easier. All you need is tidy your CV, tidy everything up, and go to your LinkedIn. You can work full-time or a contractor. It's easier if you're in a developed world. Then you can go look for job in Upwork, or I don't know if they are still accepting software developers, but you can check Upwork and register with Upwork. Then there is Upwork freelancer top that these are like freelancing marketplaces. They are freelancing marketplaces. If you register there, you put your profile there, you apply for job, they call you for interview, they give you job. I've been using Upwork for quite some time now. We also have another one like TopTal. TopTal, you have to write the exam. That is the catch with TopTal. You have to write the exam. If you write the exams and pass through their interview stage, then they will recruit you. I'm not on TopTal because I don't have time to start preparing for the exam. Then you can also try Freelancer. Freelancer is another site you can go to. You know, yeah, or even Fiverr, but I don't advise all these places you go and waste your time for $5. So if you want freelancer marketplace, go for Upwork or TopTal. That's that. If you have the time to study for their exam, then TopTal is the best. I don't really know. I can't say it's the best, but I heard they pay more than Upwork. So you can explore this option. Then there is this Angel List as well. Angel List is another website. I think it's angel.io. And if you tap Angel List on Google, it will show you the website. So what you can do, Angel List is a marketplace for startups. So startups, it's a marketplace for startups. We are investors come to invest in startup and freelancers come as well to look for job within startups. So yeah, I'm registered there, but I've not really, you just apply, but I'm not sure. I've not really done much. I've not really like gained any clients from Angel List, because sometimes most of the jobs there are kind of like on-premise job. So I think this is basically what you do. This is just all the things I want to cover in terms of getting a job. So let's summarize this. If you are in Nigeria, how do you get a job? If you are in a developed world like UK, Canada, Australia, it's a lot easier for you because everything is there for you. If you're able to go apply for a job and get a job, it's easier. If you learn software, it's just easy. All you need is just apply. You will get a job. In fact, if you know tiny software development experience and you're in the UK, US, Canada, you always get a job. It's easy. It's the employment rate of software developers in developed countries like 2%, like tiny. So you don't have any problem if you're in the developed world. If you're in Nigeria, if you are very good, local companies will employ you. Or you can go through like Andela. If you're very good, Andela could also employ you, where you work for international client via Andela. Andela is more or less just like Upwork. That is basically it. It's just like Upwork for African candidates. But of course, it's more or less, they want to model like Infosys and Wipro them. So you can, if you're in Nigeria as well, you can look for local jobs. You can go through like intermediaries like Andela, or you can also stay in Nigeria and look for international remote work. I've mentioned the EU Blue Visa. You can explore those options. In fact, I used to get so many job offerings from Belgium, Germany, Austria, Denmark. Can you go to this place? Can you go to this place for a 3-month contract? Can you go to this place for a 4-month contract? So what you can do is to see if you can get those contracts via the blue card. If you have a blue card that allows you to just hop into Germany to work, many Nigerians are doing that. So you should explore that as well. So I think that brings us to the conclusion of how to get a job. If you have any question, you can always contact me and ask me any question directly, especially if I have not covered something you have in mind of. So I think thank you very much. I think that is all.